Hello everyone and welcome back to a brand new Skillcapped guide. I'm Carnage and today I'm going to be showing you all the top 5 bad habits that you are doing as well as how you can fix them. No matter what skill level you are, I guarantee there will be some useful information in this video for you that is going to help you become a better Valorant player. But before we get into that, are you struggling to win gunfights? Well, don't worry, we got you covered. At skillcapped.com, you'll finally learn how to level up your aim, different techniques to win gunfights, and so much more. We have professional courses on every single agent, map, and mechanic in Valorant. And this is backed by the top pros, players, and coaches to make sure you're getting the most up-to-date and accurate info possible. In fact, we are so confident that you'll improve using our system that we offer a rank improvement guarantee. Check it out yourself in the link below. Simply put in what rank you're currently stuck at and find out what rank you are guaranteed by using our system. So, what are you waiting for? Unlock your true potential and get the rank you've always wanted at skillcapped.com. Link in the description below. Now moving on, our first bad habit that you need to stop immediately is related to movement. Movement in Valorant is very unique and also extremely important to understand. Specifically, I want to showcase how walking and crouching can actually be a bad tactic in a lot of situations. The main scenario that I am talking about here is while you're peeking an angle. Many times I will see players walk up to sites and continue to walk as they clear angles and take the site. In theory, this works great because you can then catch the enemy off guard, considering the fact they can't hear you. Well, it turns out this logic doesn't actually end up working out in game. The reason this doesn't work is solely because of movement speed. Movement speed in Valorant is already relatively low, so walking obviously makes you move even slower. You might be wondering, why does it matter how fast you move while peeking? Well, it's actually really important and here's why. In this clip, we see a player walk peek this angle. It's slowed down so that you can see the effects of walking a little bit more. Now, in this clip, we see a player peek this angle without walking. Could you tell the difference? Well, now let's look at these clips side by side. If we pause the clips right here, you will notice I can see this player's shoulder before they're able to see me. Well, when the player peeks this while walking, it exposes their shoulder way before they're able to see anything. If you run while peeking this angle, it will still expose your shoulder first, but it speeds this up a lot. Overall, you want to be sure you're not walk peeking angles because it is essentially giving the enemy around 100 millisecond advantage on you. Don't worry though, I have a solution for you that is going to allow you to stay quiet and still peek things safely. What you want to do is walk up to the corner or angle and then run out and jiggle peek it. If you only run for a couple steps, it actually won't make noise, but it will let you stay quick. Fixing this should help keep yourself at an even playing field against your opponents. Our next bad habit is going to be a nice 2-in-1. First off, let's talk about the easy way to boost your kill count and stay alive longer. The bad habit that many players have is choosing the wrong method of firing for their specific situation. One of the prominent examples of this is spraying enemies at a long range instead of bursting or tap firing. Most likely, in a long range encounter, you are going to want to burst or tap fire rather than spray, because it gives you much more control over your gun. Here we see a fight taking place at around 40 meters away. First, we're going to try and spray control to secure this kill. We can see it takes a decent amount of time even if your spray control is above average. Now, let's look at the same situation, but instead we're going to burst fire. We shoot 2 to 3 accurate bullets at the target, which kills them much faster. The main takeaway from this that you need to understand is that you must be adjusting how you're firing your gun based on the situation that you're in. Sometimes shooting off a couple of precise and accurate bullets is better than shooting off a large amount of less accurate bullets. To fix this bad habit, I would advise you all to practice in deathmatch, and specifically focus on what type of firing you're using during your fights. Think about what method of shooting you're going to use, and then reflect on how the fights go. This will allow you to get some practice in a low stress environment. Now, remember how I said this was a two-part tip? Well, this next part is probably one of the most common habits that I see among players. This is reloading way too often. Many times I will see a player shoot out 5 to 10 bullets and then immediately go to reload. This is a very common thing to do in games such as Fortnite or Call of Duty, but in Valorant this doesn't work. Reloading is especially dangerous in Valorant because of the amount of time it takes and the sound that it makes. When you reload, a noise is emitted which alerts the enemies to the fact that you're reloading. This makes it super easy to get caught reloading and die because of it. A safe rule that I tend to use is if I'm above 10 bullets, I will only reload if I know I am 100% safe and can't die. You really only need a couple of bullets to secure a kill, so try to limit your reloads to only when you need them, so that way you can be more prepared for the enemies. Next up, we have our third bad habit. We're going to talk about a couple of habits that revolve around abilities, all tossed into one. To start, let's talk about the ultimate ability. You get your ultimate after around 7 ultimate points, depending on what agent you play. Many times, if you're playing well, you can use your ultimate 3 or even 4 times in one half. You might notice though, this doesn't tend to happen often. One of the main reasons this is the case is because of the habit that many players are in to save their ultimate and hold on to it, waiting for the absolutely perfect moment to use it. This seems to be a common mindset among players, but this tends to decrease the amount of times you're actually able to utilize your powerful ultimate ability. Instead of waiting for the perfect moment to present itself, you should try and just find a good time to use it and commit to using it without hesitating. I'm not saying to just waste your ultimate the second that you get it though, but just try to use it within the first couple of rounds of having it so that then you can charge it back up and reuse it even more. Now, we've talked about the ultimate, so I feel like I should probably point out a bad habit that I see players making just with their normal everyday abilities. This habit encompasses a lot, so you need to pay some close attention right here. Too often, I will watch someone's gameplay and they will instantly toss out an ability that doesn't really have much use in that exact moment. For instance, many players will automatically throw a random raise pre-nade just hoping it does something. Maybe this works every now and then, but instead, if you hold on to this nade and wait for a good opportunity to present itself, you can deal a ton more damage. The same goes with a Sage Wall. Instead of instantly throwing up a Sage Wall, wait and see what the enemies are going to do. If they start to come your direction, then throw up the wall. The overarching point I'm making here is to not waste your abilities, especially at the start of the round. Instead, wait for an actual good time to use these abilities so that they are guaranteed to be useful. Alright, now you should be a master at abilities and hopefully you can break those habits and become a better player. Next though, I want to talk about our fourth bad habit that I think every single player of Valorant is guilty of at least sometimes. This habit is baiting your teammates and not trade killing. Valorant is a team game and it has to be played as one. And this is why trade killing is so important. Put simply, what you will often see is a team will push onto a bomb site. Well, as one player pushes in, the other will sit back and wait. The original player to push in might end up grabbing a kill, but he will most likely die. This is where the teammates should step in and kill the player that killed their teammate. This is called trading a kill, and doing this helps keep the game in your favor. If you simply sit back and watch your teammates run in and die, you're playing very solo-minded and hurting your team's chances at winning. Keep this concept in mind not only while attacking, but also while defending. If you're holding a bombsite and your teammate dies, try to peek out from a different angle and kill the enemy that killed your teammate. This works extremely well because it forces the enemy to try and react quickly with little information, whereas you know where the enemy is and you can easily pick up this kill. Oftentimes, focusing on helping your team is more effective and helpful than focusing on your own kills or your own life. Once you can learn this and start implementing it, you can start to win many more of your games. And finally, let's talk about habit number 5. This is more of a mistake than it is a habit, but I think it is extremely important, so I added it to this list. I'm talking about players trying to learn how to play the entire map rather than just one part. Now, this might sound dumb, but let me explain. While playing Valorant, you'll notice there are a ton of angles that you have to take into account, and overall, there's just a lot going on while you play. Well, you want to put yourself in the most comfortable position you can while playing so that you can up your chances of winning gunfights and even rounds. One of the ways you can do this is by focusing on learning one area of the map at a time. A great example of this is Haven Seasite. If you're playing Haven, automatically claim Seasite as yours and learn every single angle and ability use on the site as you can. Play on Seasite during defense and then on attack, also go to Seasite and learn how to most effectively take this site. After you master this one and become 100% comfortable with it, maybe move on to Garage and spend some time learning its angles and how to play it until you can master it. And after you learn this spot, move on to the next one and you will slowly master every part of the map. This will help you learn exactly how you should be playing every situation at all times, no matter where you are. And this is a much better way to go about improving compared to constantly changing locations. And also, a quick side tip, practice these locations in unrated so that you can improve without having to worry about your rank. It will take a good bit of time, but I promise if you put in that time and effort, you will improve a lot. And remember, if you want to improve, win more gunfights, and get the rank you've always wanted, then check out skillcaps.com, link in the description below. Alright, we just went over 5 of the most common bad habits that players have and exactly how to fix them. I threw in a ton of extra tips into this guide, so if you liked that, let me know in the comment section down below. I will personally be reading every single comment, so if you have any feedback also, let me know. And while you're down there, let me know which tip you found most useful during this guide. Thank you all for hitting that like and subscribe button. Without you, this would not be possible. And that's going to wrap up this skill-capped guide. This has been Carnage, and good luck, good half, and good game.